Texas. Opening day is here as we get the new season underway with a good matchup between the American League's Houston Astros and their in-state division rivals, the Texas Rangers. Hello again, everybody. Baseball is back. Welcome to our special opening day broadcast on MLB Network. Joined by Dan Plesac. And Dan, as we get things going this season, it's pitching that has to be key if this team's going to have success.
You know, I always think pitching and defense are the keys to success in the long run. So as the season gets started, it's going to be really important for this pitching staff to set a good tone. If they can get off on a good foot, it will do a lot for the confidence of the entire ball club.
The game's count starting now. Opening day on MLB Network, and it's coming up next. As we draw ever closer to first pitch, let's listen in to public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
And now, your 2018 Texas Rangers.
Quickly now, we'll look at the two men who are entrusted with the starting pitching assignment here to begin the new year. Now here's a look at the Astros starting lineup. Dero, daytime road game for him. What you got?
Matty, I love the way this lineup's constructed. Talking to the manager before the game, he focused on the fact that they have a pass the baton mentality. Everything's flowing for this lineup. Chance to score a lot of runs.
Cole Hamels gets the call to pitch here on opening day in front of the hometown crowd. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Cole Hamels, one of the top left-handed pitchers in the game of baseball, early on in his career with the Philadelphia Phillies, was really almost the ace of those really good Philadelphia Philly teams. His best pitch, the straight changeup. His changeup was as good as it is now when he was in high school coming out of San Diego, California. 93 to 95, will throw the overhand curveball, but primarily a two-pitch pitcher. Fastball and a lot of straight changeups.
Here's George Springer. He will lead this one off today. And there's ball two now. Our temperature, a very comfortable 72 degrees as we get things started. Now the 2-1. And a little off to begin the afternoon as it's to 3-1 now.
He's only four pitches in, but he doesn't look too sharp to start the day off.
Hit down the line at first, but a foul ball, and it's full now at 3-2. The 3-2 pitch. And a good battle continues as this ball's chopped foul at the plate, and the count remains 3-2. The 3-2 one more time. Is swung on and missed. He got him.
One thing to know is not all strikeouts are created equal. Right there, he goes down on strikes, but he really made that guy on the mound work for it. And when you're doing that in the first inning, it can have an effect on how deep he's going to be able to go into this start. There's a big difference between that and going down on three or four pitches.
Next up for the Stros, Alex Bregman, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Hit down the third baseline. Played on the backhand. Throw on to first, and Hamels has retired the first two in the inning.
Batting third, second baseman, Jose Altuve.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and striding in the speedy second baseman, Jose Altuve. Hamels ready with the 1-1. And that one stayed too low, apparently. Time to take a look at the umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Mike Fillmore.
Hey, D-Roll, Mike Fillmore, one of the most consistent umpires throughout the league. Both pitchers and position players love this guy.
Yeah, I think one of the best in the business. How I judge a good teammate is every day he opens that door. Is he consistent? Can I count on him? Mike Fillmore is the exact same way behind the dish.
3-1 to him now. Just underway in Arlington. Doesn't want any part of that cutter, and it's full 3-2. Hit hard to third. Base hit, and the Stros are into the hit column for the first time this season.
Hey, that's a heck of an effort by the third baseman right there, selling out to try and save extra bases for the pitcher, but it got through.
Carlos Correa.
Here's Carlos Correa now. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. Hamels comes set. 1-2 on its way. Reaches down and hits this one on the ground to short. Here's a flip to Odor covering, and the inning is over. A solid first inning from Cole Hamels. And now the Rangers will get their shot in a scoreless ballgame. Now time now to look at Jeff Banister's Rangers lineup card in this one. Mark DeRosa, tell us about this lineup in a daytime home contest.
Well, Matty, you walk into this yard today and it's nothing but a hitter's park. But that could work against you at times. You have to stay within yourself. You can't just be turning and burning on everything. Stay within the game plan and know that a mistake doubles leaving this yard.
Justin Verlander is on the mound for the season opener on the road in this one. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, thanks, Matt. Justin Verlander, former Cy Young Award winner. He's done just about everything you could do as a starting pitcher. At one time, might have had the best and biggest arm in the game of baseball. Consistently 94 to 97 miles an hour. Really good overhand curveball. Has the slider, has the changeup. Usually you'll know if Justin Verlander is on early. If he gets through the first couple innings, 1-2-3, he's going to be tough to beat.
And here's the second generation big leaguer, Delino DeShields. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. In for strike two. Verlander is way up there among active pitchers in terms of career wins. He's earned more than 170 of them in his time at the big leagues. And they come inside with the fastball, but it misses here, and it's back to 2-2.
That one missed, but if it's a strike, I don't know how you get the barrel of that pitch. You have to really be sitting on it to hit a fastball coming in that hard on the inside part of the plate.
Popped him up. Reddick coming on, and no one can get there. They'll try it again. Still even at 2-2. Really good at bat here from the leadoff hitter as he'll force him to throw another one. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. He can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat.
Big curveball for the strikeout there, and that came after an absolute missile of a fastball. Even if you recognize the breaking ball out of the pitcher's hand, it's so hard for hitters to sit back long enough after they've seen a really good fastball. Only the best can keep their hands back on those.
Into the box, Shin-Soo Chu.
Batter's going to have to find a way to regroup right there. That caught too much of the plate. He knew it. He missed it. He might not get another opportunity to put the ball in play.
Curveball, or maybe even the circle change there. 2-2 regardless. High pop-up. Bregman on the move. And that's the second out of the inning.
Batting third, right fielder, Nomar Mazara.
So next to the plate for Texas, Nomar Mazara. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first. To 1-2 now.
When you have two strikes on you, as a hitter, if you get something that you can handle, you have to find a way to do some damage with it. That was a missed opportunity.
Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Rangers. We are still scoreless. Next up for the Stros, Josh Reddick.
Not sure if this is a powerhouse pitching performance by both teams or bad hitting, but as we're moving late into this one, it's about time somebody put something together to try to score a run.
Ball taken there, 2-1 now. Now the 2-1 pitch is taken, ball three. Laid off as it caught the inside corner. The 3-2 pitch is a swing and a miss. That's strike three.
Batting six, the first base.
Here's Marwin Gonzalez now.
Marwin Gonzalez.
The 1-1. Swing and a liner, but foul.
That fastball must have a little late life on it, because that was right in the wheelhouse and he still wasn't able to get good wood on it.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. The next 1-2 pitch. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
Batting seven, catcher.
Stepping up now, Brian McCann will attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Now the 2-1. And this is fouled at the plate. Hamels is ready. Here he comes on 2-2. Swinging a soft liner, but an easy play over at third, and that'll be that. So Hamels had it working that half of the inning. Still nothing.
Here's the third baseman, Adrian Beltre. The 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Well, there's nothing like seeing a good power pitcher that has a good fastball. And what does he do? He just throws this good fastball right by, brings the express. No chance to put that ball in play.
Stepping in now, Joey Gallo. And this will be fouled away. Bottom of the second here with no score. Counts even 2-2 to Joey Gallo.
That pitch right there, he's trying to keep him from getting his arms extended. If it's out over the plate more, he can obviously do a lot of damage with it.
The 2-2 is looked at and the count moves full. Elvis Andrews will be next. Now the 3-2 pitch. There's a swing and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now.
Batting six, the shortstop, Elvis Andrews.
Here's Elvis Andrus now. Bases are empty here with two men out. To third. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Nothing doing against Verlander that time around. It remains nothing. There it is, the Big D, Dallas, Texas, as we welcome you back to Globe Life Park, not far away from that spot for the top of the third. Evan Gattis now standing in as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. Now the 1-1 pitch. It is a fastball in off the plate for a ball. The 2-1 will not catch the zone. Ball three.
You do not want to walk the 8-hole hitter. It just opens up so many options. Do we bunt him over to second with the 9-hole hitter? Do we try and play for that big rally with the top of the order coming up? This is a huge pitch. You can't allow this guy to walk.
Called strike two, and now it's full 3-2. Full count still.
He might not want to throw that one again. I know his timing was a little bit off at the dish, but he kept his hands back. Just missed that one. Fouled that one off really hard.
Bounce to first, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
Well executed two-seamer on the outside corner that time, and that's what you'll get a lot of with that pitch. He rolled right over it.
So coming to the plate, Derek Fisher. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Third inning, no score to this point. And that fastball is too much for him there. 1-2. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Now a swing and a miss here as he's down on strikes. So it's two up, two down to begin the third.
Boy, that's really disappointing for a guy that has wheels, right? All he wants to do is get on base and take advantage of the strength of his game, which is his speed. But with the strikeout right there, you can't get on first base if you strike out.
Standing in now, George Springer. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Two out, nobody on. And this one's going to bounce up to the plate. An easy take there, and it's 3-1 now.
This is where you cash your checks right here. 3-1, you're one of the best hitters in the game. You live for situations like this.
Inside with the fastball, and he works the base on balls.
Third baseman number two, Alex Bregman.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Alex Bregman. There are two gone and the possible go-ahead run at first. Now the 3-2 pitch. Hit in the air down the right field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Another full count pitch home. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Another full count pitch home. Grounded up the first baseline. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. So it's no runs on no hits, no errors, and one man left on. We'll head now to the home half of inning number three, and we are tied 0-0. Here's Rougned Odor now, 7, 8, and 9 to start the home third.
Not much going on offensively so far for these guys. 6 up, 6 down. We'll see if the bottom part of the lineup can get something going.
Well, the home crowd seems a little restless, so I'm sure they'd appreciate it. Now the 3-2 pitch. Hit back up the middle. Correa fields it cleanly. And that's out number one.
Batting 8, catcher Robinson Chirino.
Up next for the Rangers, Robinson Chirinos. Here now the 2-2. He stays alive, still 2-2. The 2-2 one more time. Count remains 2-2.
He wasn't fooling anybody with that fastball. He barreled it up nice right there. He's just got to find a way to keep it fair.
No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full now, 3-2. On deck, there's Jurickson Profar. Rangers still searching for hit number one in the ballgame.
Hey, he's got 4 foul balls in this AB right here. He's really making this pitcher grind for everything.
And that's low, ball 4.
They haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
Jurickson Profar.
Here's Jurickson Profar. He's got a chance to end this one and send these fans home happy if he can get a ball deep enough into the gap. Verlander deals the 3-2. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Here's the payoff pitch. Little flare out to left. And the Rangers are in the hit column. Throw comes in quickly, so the winning run advances to second now with only one away.
And the fielder.
Hey, they don't all have to be beautiful. They just have to be base hits. That's exactly what that was. Soft liner into left field. Nice job.
Into the box now. Delino DeShields. Two balls and a strike to the Rangers leadoff hitter.
Boy, he better get it back together here quick because he's got two guys on already. He's starting to lose location of that strike zone. He's got to throw a strike right here.
Now the 2-1. Down the third baseline. But this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. The 2-2. Is swung on and missed. He got him. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think you can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good high hard fastball.
Chu with a two ball, one strike count here. The 2-1 home. Swung on and missed for strike number two. Chirinos over at second. Profar at first. Two out in the inning. Now a swing and a fly ball. Should be enough to get the job done. And a relay to the plate. And the Rangers are going to win this one walk-off style.
Hey, this game looked like it was going to be one of those wild ones right from the beginning. But when you could win this thing in walk-off fashion, what a way to win a ball game. A walk-off win?
And fellas, the outing turned in by the man you see there certainly can't go unrecognized. Cole Hamill, he's our top player of the game.
Well, everyone wants to get their season off on the right foot and feel like all the hard work during the offseason and spring training has paid off. He came out here excited to play a real game again, and he really had a great game. I'm just fulfilling my destiny. To the death of me. I'm just fulfilling my destiny. I'm just fulfilling my destiny. I'm just fulfilling my destiny. To the death of me. I'm just fulfilling my destiny. Talk to God like what's next for me. I'm just fulfilling my destiny. Yeah, my pops told me he was proud. I don't think he knew what that meant to me. Yeah, you try to take advantage of me. Before you die, you'll be dead to me. Before you die, you'll be dead.
A single run good enough to do it today. 1-0 the final score. The Rangers win this one despite banging out only two hits. Paul Hamill earns his first win of the season. Justin Verlander couldn't work out of the third inning, taking the loss. So that just about does it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way on over to theshownation.com.